Hi students, in the previous session we had discussed up to larynx, the voice box. Now we will be discussing the beyond the levels of the larynx, that is from trachea onwards we will be discussing today. So the human respiratory system part 2 we can discuss it. So here trachea, commonly called as windpipe, present along the neck. It passes a tube-like structure, respiratory tube-like structure, which passes along the neck and commonly called as windpipe. It is around 10 centimeters long, roughly, not exactly, but in an average adult man, it is 10 centimeters long. And trachea is containing the incomplete cartilaginous rings, C-shaped cartilaginous rings. And which are made of hyaline cartilage. Hyaline cartilage. So C-shaped cartilaginous rings. Why? Because you see here, this is the trachea. Here the rings, ring-like structures are present here. This is the front. See here. These are the C-shaped structures here. Why C? Because it is O means complete, zero. But C means incomplete here, like this. Why it is incomplete? Because these rings are present only towards our ventral side. This is the ventral side, isn't it? Lateral side and back side is the dorsal side. So these rings are present only towards our ventral side and the lateral sides, but not the dorsal side. That's why they are incomplete cartilaginous rings. They are incomplete rings, cartilaginous rings, and which are made of hyaline cartilage. So they are absent. Backside. And what's the function of these cartilaginous rings? They prevent the trachea from collapsing. And keep trachea always open. That's the function here. In the cockroach also, tenidia present the tracheal system. What's the function of tenidia? They prevent the trachea from collapsing and keep the trachea always open. Their tenidia in the case of cockroach, and here the incomplete cartilaginous rings called as the C-shaped cartilaginous rings, which are made of hyaline cartilage. They prevent the trachea from collapsing. Even when air is not present in the trachea are not collapsing. Why the trachea are not collapsing? Because of the presence of these ring-like structures, and these ring-like structures keep the trachea always open. That's the function here. Okay, next point. The wall of trachea. For example, this is the wall of the trachea. Here are the rings. I'm not drawing these rings here. Only this one wall I'm drawing here. This is made. This is a lumen, for example. This is a lumen or cavity. And this is wall is made of two membranes. One is the mucosa and submucosa. Mucosa and submucosa. The wall of trachea is made of mucosa layer. The mucosa layer is having further two parts. One is the epithelium. Here is the epithelium, for example. This is the epithelium. And here is the layer called as this one, lamina propria. What is this called as a lamina propria? And this is the epithelial layer of mucosa. The epithelial layer of mucosa is containing the pseudo-stratified ciliated polynuclear epithelium. What is epithelium here? What is the pseudo-stratified ciliated polynuclear epithelium? Epithelium, which consists of epithelial cells. Which cells here? The pseudo-stratified ciliated polynuclear epithelial cells are present here. So the mucosa, that wall, this is a wall of trachea is having the two layers. One is a mucosal layer and this one is a submucosal layer. The mucosa is further divided into two sublayers. One is a epithelial layer and beneath the epithelial layer there is a lamina propria. So this epithelium is formed by which one? Pseudo-stratified ciliated polynuclear epithelium. That is, I am using the word ciliated. That is, it contains the cilia. One, this is one. And the epithelial cells, number two, contains the goblet cells. Goblet cells. The goblet cells secrete the mucus. Mucus secreting goblet cells are present in the trachea here. Now, what's the function of these cilia? Why cilia are present and why the mucus is present here? Because when we take oxygen, air, the environment, we are taking some dust particles, microbes like bacteria from atmosphere. They enter the, if they enter the lungs, isn't it? It may collapse the lungs. It may do some harm to the lungs, isn't it? It's not happening. Why? Because the air is entrapped. If any dust particles are present or microbial particles are present, they are entrapped by the mucus and by the ciliary action, we get some irritation. So that we are coughing and sneezing. Okay, along with the mucus, the dust particles and the microbial agents are coming out. So it's a body's defensive mechanism, one of the defensive barrier to protect the lungs here. So that is a seal. So that's why the trachea is having the pseudo-stratified ciliated pulmonary epithelium along with the goblet cells. And I told you that below the epithelium, what is the layer present? Lamina propria. The lamina propria is also important because it contains the protein called as elastin protein. Because when it is taken, some sort of elasticity should be there for the trachea, isn't it, Bacho? So some sort of elasticity is provided by elastin protein, which is present in the lamina propria here. So what is histologically here? Histologically, it contains the pseudo-stratified ciliated pulmonary epithelium and also contains the rings here, which are made of hyaline cartilage. Okay, students. So that's all about the trachea, which passes through the neck 10 centimeters and contains the ring-like structures here. Next one, this trachea passes down to the cervical, that is neck region, up to the middle of the thoracic region, mid-thoracic region. What is mid-thoracic region? The middle of the thoracic region is called as the mid-thoracic region. So what happens to this? Okay. So beyond the levels of trachea, see here, this is the trachea, 10 centimeters long, and this is the mid-thoracic region here. This is the mid-thoracic region or middle of the thoracic region. Here, above this is the diaphragm, dome-shaped structure. Above this diaphragm, this is the thorax, and below the diaphragm, this is the abdomen. Abdominal cavity and thoracic cavity are demarcated by a dome-shaped structure called as diaphragm. So this is the middle of the thoracic region. So this trachea passes down and down up to the middle of the thoracic region. This is corresponding to which one? This is corresponding to the fifth thoracic vertebrae. So let's discuss now what happens. So trachea down, it extends up to the fifth thoracic vertebrae. How many thoracic vertebrae are there totally? Type in the comment box below. Okay, how many thoracic vertebrae are there? Type in the comment box below. So this trachea extends down up to the middle of the thoracic cavity, and this is corresponding to which one? Fifth thoracic vertebrae. And then, for example, this is the corresponding to which one? Fifth thoracic vertebrae, TV. And down in now it divides into the two bronchi here. These two are the bronchi here. Can you see all of you? So this is a bronchus, right primary bronchus. This is the left primary bronchus. So what is this one? Right primary bronchus. And this is the left primary bronchus. Trachea down, fifth thoracic vertebrae divides into which one? Right and left primary bronchi. Okay, students. This primary bronchi and left primary bronchi, right primary and left primary bronchi, they enter the corresponding lung here. The right primary bronchus enters the right lung. This is the right lung. And left primary bronchus enters the left lung. This is the left lung. Clear? So each primary bronchus enters into which one? The corresponding lungs here. These are the lungs. Then the right primary bronchus divides into the secondary bronchi here. Secondary bronchi. The secondary bronchi divides into the tertiary bronchi. primary into the secondary, secondary into which one? The tertiary bronchi. All these are the three different types of bronchi. The primary bronchus into the secondary bronchus, which into the tertiary bronchus here. The tertiary bronchus now divides into the bronchioles here. What are the different types of bronchioles? Primary bronchiole. Primary bronchiole, which divides again into the secondary bronchiole. Secondary bronchiole. The secondary bronchiole again divides into the tertiary bronchiole. Tertiary bronchiole. The tertiary bronchiole further divides into the terminal bronchiole. Terminal bronchiole. Very easy, isn't it? Yes, terminal bronchiole now divides into the respiratory bronchiole. Respiratory bronchiole. The respiratory bronchiole further divides into the alveolar ducts. Alveolar ducts. The alveolar ducts ends in the alveolar sacs. Alveolar sacs here. What is the sac? Sac means a bag-like structure. A bag-like structure is called as a sac. Okay. So, see here. The trachea down from the neck, it extends up to the middle of the thoracic region, which is corresponding to which one? Fifth thoracic vertebrae. Then it divides into which one? Right primary bronchus and the left primary bronchus. Right primary and the left primary bronchus. Each primary bronchus enters the corresponding lung. This here, right lung. This here, left lung. After entering the primary bronchi, it divides into which one? Number of many secondary bronchi. Each secondary bronchus divides into tertiary bronchi. Each tertiary into the primary bronchioles now. The tertiary bronchioles divides into which one? Primary bronchioles. The primary bronchioles divides into the secondary bronchioles. The secondary bronchioles divides into many number of the tertiary bronchioles now. The tertiary bronchioles further redivides into the terminal bronchioles. The terminal bronchioles further divides into which one? The respiratory bronchioles. The respiratory bronchioles divides into which one? Gives rise to the number of alveolar ducts, and alveolar ducts gives rise to which one? Alveolar sac. A sac means a bag-like structure. Okay, students. So this is here, for example, this is a primary bronchus. It enters the corresponding lung and divides into which one? Here, this one. This enters the corresponding lung here, like this, and divides into the, see here, this is a secondary bronchus. Secondary bronchus divides into which one? Tertiary bronchus. Tertiary bronchus into which one? Divides and redivides into the many number of bronchioles here, like this. Many number of bronchioles. Here, the bronchioles can be primary bronchioles. For example, these are the primary bronchioles. The primary bronchioles divides into which one? Secondary bronchioles. The secondary bronchioles further divides into the tertiary bronchioles. The tertiary bronchioles further divides into which one? Respiratory bronchioles. Terminal bronchioles. The terminal bronchioles into the respiratory bronchioles. The respiratory bronchioles gives rise to which one? Alveolar ducts. Alveolar ducts. The alveolar ducts gives rise to the alveolar sacs. Alveolar sacs here now. Alveolar sacs. Many such things are there here, like this, divides, redivides here, many structures here, gives rise to here, many alveolar sacs here, like this, alveolar sacs here, divides and redivides into the, and ultimately ends in which one? Alveolar sacs. Sac means a bag-like structure. For example, this is a sac. Each sac contains many alveoli. Each sac contains which one? Many alveoli. Like this. They are like bunch of grapes. Angur. They are bunch of grapes. The alveolar sac, this is the alveolar sac, contains many alveoli. This is the sac, alveolar sac, contains many alveoli. Where the actual exchange of gases, respiratory gases, occur at the alveoli. This alveolus, each alveolus is approximately 0.3 to 0.5 millimeters. That is very, very small, microscopic in nature, isn't it? Alveoli, alveolus, where the actual exchange of gas is occurring here. So this is like a tree here, isn't it? Bachcho, all of you see here. This is like a tree. How is the tree? Example, you take this is a trunk. Trunk contains the branches, which divides the branch sub branches and divides into many sub branches, isn't it? The same way here, like this here, it's like a tree. That is, but it is an inverted tree. That is ulta. When the tree is inverted, how it looks like? So it is like a inverted tree, and which is for us a pulmonary tree. Why? Because everything related to the lungs is for us pulmonology. Pulmonary, isn't it? Pulmonology, the study of lungs. Anything pulmonary means related to the lungs. So it is happening in the lungs. That's why it's for us a pulmonary tree. Pulmonary tree here. Pulmonary tree, and it's happening because of the combination of which one? Trachea and the bronchi. Trachea and the bronchi. That's why it's also called as a tracheobronchiolar tree. Or also called as a tracheobronchiolar tree. Bronchiolar tree here. Because it's happening because of the combination of the trachea and the bronchi. That's why this one here. So this here. Now this bronchi, whether it can be primary, secondary and tertiary bronchi, all here, all bronchi, they are lined by the smooth muscles. Smooth muscles. Their walls are having the smooth muscles which can contract and relax here during the breathing. And it's also having the incomplete cartilaginous rings. It's also lined by the incomplete cartilaginous rings. All the bronchi, primary, secondary and tertiary bronchi. Next one is the bronchioles, which are all these bronchi are present in, bronchioles are present in the lungs itself, isn't it? So bronchioles, bronchioles, that is primary, secondary, tertiary and terminal. Bronchioles are also having the smooth muscles along with the, they are also lined by the incomplete cartilaginous rings. They are also lined by the incomplete cartilaginous rings. So bronchi and bronchiolar walls, they are having the smooth muscles. Why the smooth muscles or involuntary muscles are there? Because some expansion, this contraction and relaxation, expansion must be there. For this one, what is necessary here? For expansion of these lungs, what is missing here? These bronchi and bronchioles must be expanding here. For this one, contraction and relaxation are necessary. That's why bronchi and the bronchioles are having the smooth muscles here. And the bronchi are also having the incomplete cartilaginous rings, and bronchioles up to the terminal bronchioles are also having the incomplete cartilaginous rings here. Okay, students. And bronchi also contains of goblet cells here. Remember this point. Mucus secreting cells, for us, goblet cells are also present in the bronchi, and to some extent they are also present in the bronchioles. Clear, students? Now this alveoli. Alveoli, I told you. Where are these alveoli present? The respiratory bronchioles. The respiratory bronchioles. They give rise to which one? Alveolar ducts. Alveolar ducts. Each alveolar duct gives rise to which one? Alveolar sacs. Sac means a bag-like structure. So each bag-like structure, for example, this is the respiratory bronchiole. This is the respiratory bronchiole. The respiratory bronchiole gives rise to which one? Here. This is the terminal bronchiole, for example. This is the terminal bronchiole. The terminal bronchiole gives rise to which one? Respiratory bronchiole. The respiratory bronchiole into the duct called as here alveolar duct. Example, this is the alveolar duct. Alveolar duct. The duct gives rise to which one? A sac-like structure here, a bag-like structure. And each sac, this is the alveolar sac. Alveolar sac is a bunch, which contains a bunch of grape-like structures here, called as the alveoli. These are having the many structures here, rounded structures are there. These are called as the alveoli here. Each one is called as alveolus. See here, it is now having the alveoli. The sac contains the alveoli here. where the actual exchange of gases occur in this one, alveoli here. Okay, students, how many alveoli are there? Alveoli, number of alveoli. Alveoli number 300, literally 300 million alveoli are present here. 300 million, where 1 million is equal to 10 lakhs. So 300 million alveoli, which are of 0.3 to 0.5 millimeters in size, 300 million. And they increase the surface area of respiratory exchange of gases, just like the villi are doing in the small intestine. But show, what is a villi doing in the small intestine? They increase the surface area of absorption of the digested food, isn't it? The same way, the alveoli are increasing the respiratory surface area of exchange of gases here. They are doing so much favor to the human lungs, isn't it? Because they are increasing the surface area, so that the surface area of the respiratory surface is 100 meters square, approximately, not exactly. It is around 18 meters square to the 100 meters square here. That is a respiratory surface of exchange of gases because of the 300 million alveoli present in the human lungs. Clear, students? So now, lungs, let's discuss now. Lungs. Study of lungs is called as pulmonology. See here, the nasal channel, external nostrils, where we breathe in oxygen, respiratory exchange of gases at the external nostrils, and communication with the atmosphere. Nasal chambers. And nasal chambers, so the internal nostrils, pair of internal nostrils are present. Into the nasopharynx. Nasopharynx open into which one? Oropharynx. Which into the laryngopharynx. Laryngopharynx into the larynx. And larynx into which one? The trachea here. Larynx into the trachea here. The trachea, now what is connected to which one? The primary bronchi. Primary bronchi. The primary into the secondary bronchi. The secondary into the tertiary bronchi. The tertiary into the tertiary bronchi into the bronchioles here. Primary bronchioles and primary bronchioles into the secondary bronchioles, the secondary bronchioles into the tertiary bronchioles. See here, this one is called as the conducting part of the human respiratory system. This is called as the conducting part. We take in oxygen, give out carbon dioxide. That is our nose, nostrils are in communication. The nasal chamber, total cavity, this nasal passage is in communication with the external atmosphere to the external nostrils here. So external nostrils, the air is passing inside the nasal chambers, and to the nasal chambers, internal nostrils, they pass here to the nasopharynx, to the oropharynx, to the laryngopharynx, to the larynx, trachea, primary bronchi, secondary bronchi, tertiary bronchi, primary bronchioles, secondary bronchioles, and tertiary bronchioles. Up to here is for us a conducting part. Why? Because this is conducting here. Oxygen is when we respire, when we breathe inside, oxygen, we may breathe in more temperature. What is the normal temperature of human being? 37 degrees Celsius. When we are present in Shimla, for example, where the temperature is 5 degrees Celsius, that is we are breathing how much? 5 degrees Celsius. But and on the other hand, when we are present in desert, where the temperature is, for example, 45 to 50, we are respire, breathing that one. But is it entering the human lungs? No. Why? Because this passage, chiefly on the other day we were discussing, the nasal chambers are having the conchae, isn't it? Conchae or terminals, which humidifies the air. It is bringing to the air is brought to the normal body temperature, plus humidification is there here. That's the main function of the conchae present or terminals present in the nasal chambers. So here, these filter the dust particles, because I told you just now that the trachea is having the pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium. It contains the cilia and contains the goblet cells, which is secretes the mucus. When the mucus is secreted, these dust particles and bacteria are entrapped, we get some irritation and they are sneezed out here. That is, this conducting part is doing the two main functions. One is humidifying the air, humidifies the air, number one. Number two is filters the dust particles, filters the dust particles and microbes, bacteria, etc. So that's the function of the conducting part. Now next one, what is the next one? The respiratory part. So what is the respiratory part? The tertiary bronchioles, as you know, is now divided into which one? Respiratory here, bronchioles. The tertiary bronchioles divided into which one? The terminal bronchioles here. Tertiary bronchi, primary into the secondary, the tertiary bronchi, and primary bronchioles, secondary bronchioles, tertiary bronchioles, and next one is the terminal bronchioles. Next one is the terminal bronchioles here. Terminal bronchioles. All these form the connecting part up to the terminal bronchioles. That is external, from external nostrils up to the terminal bronchioles is called as the connecting part. The terminal bronchioles divides into which one? Respiratory bronchioles. They divide into the respiratory bronchioles. The respiratory bronchioles divides into which one? Alveolar ducts. Alveolar ducts. Alveolar ducts into which one? Alveolar sacs. Alveolar sacs. So these respiratory bronchioles, alveolar ducts and alveolar sacs, they comprises the respiratory part. They comprises the respiratory part. So basically two parts are there in the human respiratory system. What is that? One is for the conducting part from external nostrils up to the terminal bronchioles. Whereas the respiratory part, it comprises the respiratory bronchioles, alveolar ducts and alveolar sacs. And the sacs, as you know, contains the alveoli with the which contributing the actual exchange of gases. This one is actually doing the contributing the exchange of gases here. This is just conducting here. Air is conducted, but actual exchange is done by which one? These three parts here. That's why this is called as the respiratory part. Show clear. And this is called as here. Next one, the huge study of lungs is called as pulmonology. Anything pulmonary means related to the lungs. Now location of lungs, first point, what is the, where the lungs located, location, they are present in the thoracic region. This is the thoracic region, above the diaphragm is the thoracic region, this is the diaphragm, above the thorax is the, above the diaphragm is the thorax, this is the thoracic cavity. So major part of thoracic cavity is occupied by the lungs. And between the space between the two lungs, see here, this is called as a mediastinum. The space between the two lungs where the heart is located is called as a mediastinum. Mediastinum is a space between the two lungs where the heart is located. See here, a single heart, a small heart is there. The lungs are very larger conical shaped structures. And between the two lungs, some small space is there. That's called as a mediastinum. In the mediastinum, what is present? The heart is located here, heart, human heart here, clear students. And this heart, lungs are the conical shaped structures, very large structures here, and they occupy most of the part of the thoracic cavity, clear students. And they are bodies of protection, bodies of protection here. The lungs are protected towards the lateral sides, towards the lateral sides, 12 pairs of ribs are present, 12 pairs of ribs. In this one, thoracic ribs chiefly, they protect the lungs here. Towards the thoracic region, thoracic ribs, they protect the human lungs. That is a bony protection, number one. Pairs of ribs here, chiefly thoracic ribs. Number one. Number two is, towards the ventral side, the front part is called as ventral part and back part is called as a dorsal part. So towards the ventral part, see here, in this part, in the chest region, in the front of the heart, there is a bone called as breastbone or sternum. Sternum. Towards the ventral side, sternum here. So towards the lateral side, ribs are present, and towards the ventral side, sternum or breastbone is protecting the lungs. Clear? And towards the posterior side, what is present? Diaphragm. Is present here. This is the diaphragm present towards the posterior side. So, as a result of this one, the lungs are formed into an airtight chamber. It is formed into an airtight chamber. Why it's an airtight chamber? Because it is protected on all sides. It is a totally locked one. Towards the posterior side, diaphragm, towards the ventral side, sternum bone is there, and towards the lateral side, the ribs are present. So it's an airtight chamber. So that when there is a change in the thoracic cavity, any change in the thoracic cavity is also reflected in the volume of the lungs. That is, pulmonary volume is directly proportional to which one? Change in the thoracic cavity, which is useful for the breathing of the human beings here. Clear, students? That's the anatomical production of the lungs. Next one, the lungs are conical shaped structures, and they are protected by the pleural membranes, called as pleurites. Two pleural membranes are there. Membranous protection. For example, this is a lung, and this is having the two layers are there. One is outer layer called as the serous parietal layer. The outer layer is called as the parietal pleural membrane. And inner one is called as the serous pleura. Outer parietal, this is the outer parietal, where I have drawn the greenish structure, this outer parietal, and inner one is called as the serous. Gap is present between these two here, isn't it? That's called as a peripleural cavity. What is this called as a pleural cavity? The gap is present between the two layers, outer parietal and inner serous layer. Some gap is there, and it's called as a pleural cavity. Now you see here, the parietal pleura is in contact. What is this one? The chest lining, the rest of the chest lining, that is thoracic lining. The parietal pleura is in contact with the chest lining or rest of the thoracic lining. Whereas the serous lina, this is the inner one called as the serous lina. It is in contact with which one? Actual lung surface. Here. And between these two, what is present, Pacho? The cavity called as a pleural cavity is there. The pleural cavity is filled with the pleural fluid. This is called as a pleural fluid. What is the function of fluid? It prevents the friction between the two layers. Okay, friends. So this is about the lungs. Next one is the diaphragm. The most important structure here is called as other important structure, diaphragm here. It is a muscular structure. Smooth muscles are present. It is also having the fibers. So it is a fibromuscular structure. Is very rough and strong because it has to protect the lungs. It has to separate the thoracic cavity from the abdominal cavity. That's why it is very strong. It is made of fibers, and it is also muscular, fibromuscular structure. Okay, students, diaphragm. It is dome-shaped structure. What is the shape of this one? It's a dome-shaped structure. So now let's discuss the diaphragm. It's a dome shaped structure, fibromuscular structure, and separates which one? Thoracic cavity from abdominal cavity. That's the function here. And diaphragm muscles called as phrenic muscles. Hence in pulmonary respiration. The respiration of the lungs is called as a pulmonary respiration or ventilation. So the pulmonary ventilation is chiefly aided by the phrenic muscles of diaphragm. Anything phrenic means it is related with the diaphragm. Phrenic nerves means the nerves of the diaphragm. Isn't it? Phrenic vessels, blood vessels here. That is the vessels, blood vessels of the diaphragm. In the same way, phrenic muscles helps in the respiratory exchange of gases here. It helps in the pulmonary ventilation. Dear students, if there is a hole, for example, accidentally there is a hole, for example, the person will die because if the hole means it's a major problem, the person will die here. It's an examination question, bachcho, clear? Now, these lungs are less elastic in the case of birds. Here we are discussing the human respiratory system, including the all the mammals, where the diaphragm is present here. Isn't the diaphragm is a very developed structure in the mammals. But in the birds, yes, the diaphragm is absent. Note this point. In the birds or yes, the diaphragm is absent. The lungs are less elastic in birds. And the air sacs aid in pulmonary respiration in the case of birds. And in the crocodiles, the diaphragmatic structure is present, whereas in the rest of the reptiles, the diaphragm is absent. The only reptile where the diaphragm-like structure, not exactly diaphragm, but diaphragm-like structure is present in the crocodiles here. Okay, students, that's all about for today. In the next lecture, we'll be discussing the mechanism of breathing. Okay, bye, students.